city of T.O. When I stop inside a little bar, a place I often go, I ordered up the rum and coke and was reaching for the fee, when a little hand laid a dollar down, said, "Sir, the drink's on me." Well, I turned around, saw her Colgate smile. She was too sweet to be true. Her hair was like the sunset, and her eyes were God's own blue. Her pretty clothes, her freckled nose, it was beauty wild and free. And my eyes rolled round when I heard her say, "Sir, will you marry me?" She never spoke, I know, for an hour or so, and then I heard her say, "My daddy, he's an oil man in the good old USA. He'll be so proud, you'll be his son, have a share in the Texan gold. You have nothing to do, only sit at home, watch the pig and whistle show." Oh, the church was darn near empty when I signed away my life. The parson sweetly smiled and said, "I'd pronounce you man and wife." As I walked the aisle, my face was smiles and I held on to her hand. But I almost cried when she said, "I lied, I came from Newfoundland." Well, very next day we were on our way to that island in the sea, into an unknown future, not knowing what my life would be. Well, in Port of Bass, 'twas there I asked, "How will I earn my bread?" She said, "It's fish and welfare, the way my daddy did." Well, the bus had stopped and out we got, her dad was standing there, his rubbers pulled up o'er his knees, spitting baccy in the air. It was twice as dark as Miller's cave, I was almost scared to death. He said, "It's not Toronto, boy, we've no electricity yet. Now I'm tucked away and I'm here to stay, but there's one thing that I know. I'll never more see my western home or the pig and whistle show. But if you ever come to Newfoundland, come and see me in my camp. I'll be in the bed reading comic books by the light of the kerosene lamp. I'll be in the bed reading comic books by the light of the kerosene lamp."